introduction is the introduction of chemical particulates, biological material, or other harmful materials into Earth's atmosphere, possibly causing disease, death to human, or damage to other living things.
An air pollutant is a substance in the air that can have adverse effect on human and the ecosystem. The substance can be solid particles, liquid droplets, or gases. A pollutant can be natural or a man-made. Pollutants are classified as primary or secondary. Primary pollutants are usually produced from a process such as ash from a volcanic eruption. Other examples include carbon monoxide gas from motor vehicle exhaust or the sulfur dioxide released from the factories. Secondary pollutants are not emitted directly. Rather, they form in the air when primary pollutants react in or interact.
Our major primary pollutants are sulfur oxide, nitrogen oxide, carbon monoxide, and toxic metal, chlorofluorocarbon, ammonia, odors, radioactive pollutants.
Sulfur oxide, produced by volcanoes and various industrial processes. Coal and petroleum often contain sulfur compounds and their combustion generates sulfur dioxide. Nitrogen oxide, expelled from high temperature combustion and are also produced during thunderstorm by electrical discharge. Carbon monoxide is a product by incomplete combustion of fuel such as natural gas, coal, or wood vehicular exhaust. Is a major source of carbon monoxide. Toxic metal, such as a lead monoxide, is a product by incomplete combustion of fuel such as natural gas, coal, or wood. Vehicular exhaust is a major source of carbon monoxide. Toxic metal is such as lead and mercury, especially their compounds. Chlorofluorocarbons are gases which are released from air conditioners, refrigerators, aerosol. Toxic metals, such as lead and mercury, especially their compounds. Chlorofluorocarbons are gases which are released from air conditioners, refrigerators, aerospray, etc. Ammonia, emitted from agricultural processes. Odors, such as from garbage, sewage, and industrial processes. Radioactive pollutants produced by nuclear explosion, nuclear event, were explosive.
Sources of air pollution is composed of two main sources. The first one is the anthropogenic sources, which is also called man-made sources, and the second one is the natural sources. Anthropogenic or man-made sources is composed of the stationary sources, mobile sources, third one is the chemicals, fourth is the fumes, fifth one is the waste deposition, and lastly is the military resources.
Stationary sources include smokestacks of power plants, manufacturing facilities, and waste incinerators. Mobile sources include motor vehicles, marine vessels, and aircraft. Chemicals, dust and controlled burn practices in agriculture and forest management. Fumes, from paint, hairspray, varnish, aerosol sprays, and other solvents. Waste deposition in landfills, which generate methane. Methane is highly flammable and may form explosive mixtures with air. Lastly, military resources such as nuclear weapons, toxic gases, germ warfare, and rocketry. Natural sources. Dust from natural sources, usually large areas of land with few or no vegetation. Methane, emitted by the digestion of food by animals, for example, cattle. Radon gas, from radioactive decay within the Earth's crust. Smoke and carbon monoxide from wildfires. Volcanic activity, which produces sulfur, chlorine, and ash particulates.
The effects of air pollution, respiratory and heart problems, global warming, and acid rain.
Respiratory and heart problems. The effects of air pollution are alarming. They are known to create several respiratory and heart conditions along with cancer that threats to the body. Children in areas exposed to air pollutants are said to commonly suffer from pneumonia and asthma. Global warming. Another direct effect is the immediate alteration that the world is witnessing due to global warming. With increased temperatures worldwide, increase in sea levels and melting of ice from colder regions and icebergs, displacements and loss of habitat have already signaled an impending disaster if actions for prevention and normalization aren't undertaken soon. Acid rain. Harmful gases like nitrogen oxides and sulfur oxides are released into the atmosphere during the burning of fossil fuels. When it rains, the water droplets combined with these air pollutants become acidic and then falls on the ground in the form of acid rain. Acid rain can cause great damage to human, animals, and crops.
Other effects of air pollution, eutrophication, effects on wildlife, depletion of ozone layer.
Eutrophication is a condition where high amount of nitrogen present in some pollutant gets developed on sea surface and turns itself into algae and adversely affects fish, plants, and animal species. The green-colored algae that is present on lakes and ponds is due to presence of this chemical only. Effects on wildlife. Just like humans, animals also face some devastating effects of air pollution. Toxic chemicals present in the air can force wildlife species to move to new place and change their habitat. The toxic pollutants deposit over the surface of the water and can also affect sea animals. Depletion of ozone layer. Ozone exists in Earth's stratosphere and is responsible for protecting humans from harmful ultraviolet rays. Earth's ozone layer is depletion due to the presence of chlorofluorocarbons, hydrofluorocarbons in the atmosphere.
There are 5 solutions for air pollution. First, the use of public mode of transportation. Second is conserve energy. Third, understand the concept of reuse, reduce, and recycle. Emphasize on clean energy resources. And the last one is the use of energy-efficient devices.
Number 1, use public mode of transportation. Encourage people to use more and more public modes of transportation to reduce pollution. Also try to make carpooling. If you and your colleagues come from the same locality and have same timings, you can explore this option to save energy and money. Number 2, conserve energy. Switch off fans and lights when you are going out. Large amount of fossil fuels are burned to produce electricity. You can save the environment from degradation by reducing the amount of fossil fuels to be burned. Number 3, understand the concept of reduce, reuse, and recycle. Do not throw away items that are of not use to you. In fact, reuse them for some other purpose. Number 4, emphasis on clean energy resources. Clean energy technologies like solar, wind, and geothermal are on high these days. Governments of various countries have been providing grants to consumers who are interested in installing solar panels for their home. This will go a long way to curb air pollution. Lastly, use energy-efficient devices. CFL lights consume less electricity as against their counterparts. They live longer, consume less electricity, lower electricity bills, and also help you to reduce pollution by consuming less energy.